Well, that wasn't so bad, was it? It's not fear I smell, is it?
The last one to arrive is finally here. I hope you don't think you're special. It would be a shame if freedom went to your head. Or if you somehow got the idea you didn't need to pass your trials to become Sith. Lord Zash has tasked me with sorting through you refuse to find one worthy of being her apprentice, and I intend to do just that.
Please, don't get all sentimental on us. We've only just met.
I won't. Now the rest of you gutter trash already know your trial. Get going while I bring our latecomer up to speed.
Watch your back, friend. And don't worry. It'll be all right. He can't kill us all.
A Sith fears no one.
Suit yourself.
Now, slave, for your trial. There's a hermit named Spindrol who lives in the tomb of Ajunta Paul in the Valley of the Dark Lords. Spindrol's a lunatic, but Lord Zash sees him as some kind of prophet. Once you find him, he will test you.
The more challenging, the better.
But there, you know your task. Spindrol lives in the tomb of Ajunta Paul in the Valley of the Dark Lords. Don't keep Spindrol waiting, slave.
Excuse me, Acolyte. Sergeant Corman, 5th Infantry Company, Corriban Regiment. Can I talk to you?
Speak freely, Sergeant.
Thank you. You're one of the slaves Harkon brought in on the last transport, right? Here to prove yourself to the bloodthirsty overseers?
Yes, that's me all right.
Well,
Here's your chance to not only show off for the overseers, but start building ties to the Imperial military as well. I'm here commanding a hard target mission to exterminate claw slugs in this tomb. They're horrific things. Mouths bigger than your head. I've lost 3 squads of good men fighting them. They come in packs. They'll swallow a man whole.
If you're trying to talk me out of this, it won't work.
Understood. I was hoping you could assist my operation while you're in there. The damn claw slugs breed so fast, there's no way to wipe them out conventionally. So we started targeting their egg chambers. They went insane. We managed to get explosives to all of the egg chambers, but the claw slugs were all over us before we could detonate them.
Are you sure this plan of yours will actually work?
I don't know. I have to hope so. Without breeding chambers, the claw slugs lose the numbers. Then we can wipe them out. Don't underestimate those claw slugs, sir. They're smarter than they look. I heard the explosions when you set off the charges. Outstanding, sir.
What dark secret shall I share with you? Be gone.
Slave, welcome to my humble hole. You are here for your trial, yes? Learn the ways of the Sith from a doddering old man in a tomb, and hopefully to return to your master with the mark of my approval.
Yes, my lord, that's right.
Of course it is. I know the way of things on the surface. But before I answer either way, you must pass a trial of blood. Survive, and I will teach you what I know. Excellent. These former acolytes wanted nothing more than to earn their second chance for glory by killing you and taking your place. But your desire proved stronger, and their blood became the mantle of your victory. Well done. But you are not Sith yet. Peace is a lie. There is only passion. Through passion, I gain strength. Through strength, power. Through power, victory. Through victory, my chains are broken. This is the Sith Code. Commit it to your heart, and you will have the strength to crush your enemies. Do you understand?
Yes, I think I do. I must use my emotions to grow strong.
Do not be timid. Humility is the attitude of a slave, not a Sith. Now go. Return to Harkon and nurture your hatred for him. And use your fear of him to grow stronger. He may raise his fist to strike,
but it is Lord Zash who determines where the blow will land.
How do you know Harkon and Lord Zash?
Both of them have been through here in my time, and they have gone their separate paths since. Now, go. Leave me to my rest.
Last, a worthy disciple. Be gone.
I have taken care of your problem with the looters in the tomb.
Ah, then I'll assume my men are dead. Even so, you have done us a great service. Their loss is your gain, I suppose.
I am most grateful.
Yes, sir.
Again.
You must be one of the slave acolytes. Pretty easy to see why Overseer Harkon was horrified. Regardless, Lord Zash has made it clear that all new acolytes must learn martial skills as well as face their trials. Though why anyone thinks you can be taught is beyond me.
Watch yourself. I don't respond well to idiots with big egos.
I'm fluttering with fear. Fluttering. You will find the instructors in the Academy's archive. Hurry. And try not to embarrass your betters.
What dark secret shall I share with you? Be gone.
Ah, the last one. Always the latecomer. Now we can see what the Hermit thinks of you, Slime. Acolyte Cory. Step forward, please.
Yes, Overseer.
You are a weak, pathetic rodent, and even a lunatic like Spindrawl can see this. And that means... Meet our newcomer, Fon Alt. This is real Sith strength, and he will tear you apart and crush your bones, slaves. Look on him. No connections left in the world, but pure Sith blood. This is Lord Zash's future apprentice, not filth like you.
We'll see how tough he is out in the tombs. Alone, with just me and my blade for company.
Step this way, slave. I want to speak to you privately. The rest of you, get out of here. You know your trials. You too, Fon. Spindrawl awaits. Now, listen to me. Spindrawl is a lunatic. His approval means nothing. You are filth, and you will die. Is that clear?
You think you scare me?
You're nothing, and don't forget it. Now, your second trial. Lord Zash has requested a special trial for you, which you will no doubt fail. Go to Inquisitor Zinn in the jails. He will fill you in on the details, and most likely hasten your demise.
Don't count on my demise, Harkon. I don't die easy.
Don't boast, slave. I don't want to see you again until you're back from the jails. That's all.
Acolyte, you've arrived. And not a moment too soon. Harkon has given me very specific instructions. You were raised as a slave, but must discard those traits and learn to control others. And I have just the task for that end. Meet this driveling excuse for an acolyte. He will be your victim.
Victim, hmm? This sounds like it could be fun.
This is not an idle diversion, acolyte. A short while ago, there was what we call an unauthorized murder here in the Academy. A rivalry among apprentices resulted in death. Interrogate him. Make him tell you who committed this crime at any cost.
Cover your ears. This may get a little loud.
Thank you for the warning, but I prefer to cherish every scream. Thank you.
Please, don't hurt me. I don't know anything.
Scream, weakling. I want to hear your suffering.
Please, don't do that again. I'll do anything.
Entertain me. Give me a song or something.
Sing? Are you serious? I mean, sure. Yes, I... What should I...
Something in the higher registers.
Stop! Please! All right, I'll talk. You'll kill me, but I'll talk. The murderer is an apprentice named Essor Kayan. You have to protect me, or he'll kill me.
I doubt that. He'll be too busy being punished for murder.
Kayan's master is a Dark Council member. Might as well try fighting the Emperor himself. Kayan won't get so much as a reprimand. But when Kayan finds out, he'll come after me.
Not if I have any say in the matter.
It's a nice thought, but I doubt it. Maybe you could persuade the Inquisitor to protect me. Unlikely, though. It's not the Sith's way.
You don't have to tell me. I heard the name loud and clear, though I sorely wish I hadn't. Essor Kayan. Kayan's master is a Dark Council member. I'd be a fool to oppose him. But anyway, your trial here is done. I will send my commendations to Overseer Harkon. You may return to him now.
That acolyte is going to need protection.
Concern for matters that are not your business is a weakness that will get you killed. I suggest you eliminate this undesirable trait as quickly as possible and forget about this acolyte.
So you're just going to let yourself be bullied?
And what would you suggest? I don't have the power to oppose a Dark Council member, and neither do you.
Do I have to force you to help?
You are a mere fledgling, acolyte. Don't think you can scare me. Now, if you'll excuse me. I have more important things to do than argue with a slave.
I had been looking forward to cutting another one of you down, but it looks like I'll be spared the trouble. Unsurprisingly, Nylock has gone missing. Also, unsurprisingly, Fon has passed his first trial. It's only a matter of time before he tramples you all underfoot.
I'll tear you apart where you stand, slave.
Patience, Fon. An accident in the tombs is much more convincing. Now the lot of you know your next task. Go. I want to speak to Fon and our latecomer. Now, slave. Zin says you handled yourself expertly, and as much as I find this difficult to believe, Lord Zash is satisfied with his evaluation. Undoubtedly, Zin helped you in some way. But you will not have his help on the next trial. Both you and Fon will have trials of intellect, trials that test your ability to apply your understanding of the Force to solve problems.
You don't expect a slave to be a match for me in intellect. I've been trained under the greatest teachers.
Calm down, Fon. I certainly do not expect this slave to be a match for you. That's why you will have separate trials.
Truly, your generosity astounds.
You're only digging your own grave, Fon. You will go to the library on the second floor of the academy and translate the following texts for Lord Zash.
Yes, Overseer.
Slave, deep in the ancient, monster-infested tomb of Marka Ragnos, there is a holocron filled with dark secrets and encased in a great stone monument. No one has figured out how to release the holocron from its stone prison in over 1,000 years. You will bring this holocron to me, or you will die.
Hey, it beats going to the library. Yawn.
Spoken like the idiot you are. You will bring back the Holocron, or hope that the spirit of Mark Aragnos himself returns to end your miserable existence. Now go.
What dark secret shall I share with you? Be gone.
Stand and account for yourself, Acolyte. Let's see what you're made of. I look at you, and I wonder, are you among the truly loyal, or do you hide treason in your heart?
Don't be a fool.
Defiance of authority is a hallmark of the immature and the subversive. I recommend you reconsider your attitude.
There's one threat our Empire must remain forever vigilant against. Those within our own ranks who undermine and weaken us.
Intelligence reports indicate this valley shelters traitors. Acolytes who seek to destroy our Emperor's carefully built order and replace it with their own weak-minded heresies.
They hide among the faithful and obedient. But make no mistake, they will destroy us all, given the chance.
We've watched as the traitors scuttle about this valley and plot against us. We know their faces and their names. It is the Emperor's will that the sands of Korriban be slaked with the blood of these traitors. Prove your allegiance by executing them.
It will be a great honor to serve you, my lord.
And in serving me, you serve the Emperor. Remember that as you exterminate those vermin in the valley.
I'll give you the means to identify the traitors. Eliminate enough of them to prove your loyalty. Then return to Inquisitor Arzanen.
I'll be watching your progress with great interest. Go now. See that the Emperor's will be done.
Your money's always good here. Come again. See anything you like? Come again.
I watched you deal with those traitors. Well done. That was an impressive display of loyalty. Take this reward as a token of the Emperor's favor, and wear this badge. It marks you as a defender of our empire.
Stay vigilant. Our enemies lurk where you least expect them.
Confirmed.
A fresh, young acolyte come to view my experiments. Good. I trust the sight of a messy operating table doesn't disturb you.
The path to power is not for the faint-hearted.
You remind me of myself at your age. This used to be a Tukata, the hound-like creatures infesting Korriban's tombs. On the surface, nothing special. But I alone can see this creature is an expression of pure dark side energy. Aggression made manifest.
Amazing. How did you learn that?
The Force told me so. It speaks to me. The Force is alive. It expresses its will in the physical world. This Tukata was one such form.
Are we another of these forms?
Sith are the highest manifestation of the Force's will. I've dissected hundreds of Tukata, forging a direct connection to the dark side. Each beast I examine advances me toward perfect unity. I now stand at a new frontier, but find myself thwarted. My most perfect specimen, a Tukata mutant, escaped to the tombs before I could analyze it.
Perhaps I could help recover your specimen.
Yes, I was hoping as much. My apprentice, Melora, saw which tomb the mutant beast fled into. Find out what she knows, assist me, and you will be rewarded.
I'll speak with Melora and do whatever is necessary, my lord.
You found a great calling in my service. I trust you appreciate that.
Seeking Lord Renning's lost pet, are you? Don't waste your time. That fool's research is pointless. Not a very loyal apprentice, are you? He's my master in title only. He has nothing to teach anyone about the dark side of the Force. Renning deludes the Dark Council into believing he's advancing Sith knowledge. The truth is, he wastes the Empire's time and resources dissecting mindless animals. But if his experiments were discredited, he would be banished, and I would be rewarded.
You're just scheming to get rid of your master.
I have a greater destiny than serving as a research assistant in this pathetic excuse for a laboratory. Look, just a minor alteration to the mutant Tukata's brain would allow me to reveal my master as a fraud. Bring me the brain before delivering it to Lord Renning. and I'll make it worth your while. Betraying your master carries considerable risk. The greater the risk, the greater the reward. For both of us. The mutant Ukat escaped to the tomb of Mark of Ragnos. It's much larger than the others, so it's easy to spot. Return to me with the brain before you see Lord Renning, and I'll take care of the rest.